नमस्ते एंड वेलकम टू प्लेनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी. सो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. एंड टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सीरीज ऑफ नक्षत्रास. आई हैव डन वीडियोस ऑन सर्टेन नक्षत्रास, सो प्लीज़ यू गो थ्रू ऑल दोज वीडियोस. यू कैन जस्ट विजिट माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्लेनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी फॉर दैट. एंड टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट श्रवण नक्षत्र. दिस इज अ मून चंद्र नक्षत्र. श्रवण नक्षत्र इज बेसिकली मेड अप ऑफ थ्री मेजर स्टार्स. दे आर फॉर्म्ड इन वन अलाइनमेंट, वन लाइन, एंड द मिडल स्टार इज लिटिल बिट ग्रीनिश इन कलर एंड विच इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड विच इज वेरी स्पार्कलिंग स्टार, विच इज कॉल्ड एज श्रवण. This Shravan Nakshatra is fully seen, or you can just observe this Shravan Nakshatra very clearly in the month of August, in around full moon day. In Hindu this language we call it as around Purnima. In Shravan month, means see all months in Hindu calendar is कार्तिके, सो मार्गशीर्ष, मृगशीर्ष, लाइक दैट. सो श्रवण नेम इज गिवन आफ्टर सर्टेन माइथोलॉजिकल स्टोरी. ऑल द नक्षत्रास हैव सर्टेन माइथोलॉजिकल स्टोरी, सो एज श्रवण नक्षत्र. आई विल टेल यू इन शॉर्ट व्हाट इज द स्टोरी ऑफ श्रवण नक्षत्र, व्हाई दिस श्रवण नक्षत्र इज गिवन नेम एज अ श्रवण, एंड व्हाई दिस टू stars and the middle star is very prominent and green in color. See, there was a child named as Shravan Kumar, and he dedicated his whole life in looking after and in giving services to his parents, because his parents were blind, they could not see anything, and Shravan Kumar was the child, was the person who did all work for his parents, and he loved his parents very blindly, very madly. And wherever he used to travel, he just made a coward. You can just imagine, you can just compare this coward with the weighing machine, you know. So that he used to make two baskets, he used to tie with one stick, and he used to take the whole weight, whole vajan on his shoulder, and he used to take his parents all around wherever he wanted, wherever he and wherever they wanted to travel. So one fine day when he was traveling through the jungle, that time his parents were thirsty and they asked their son that, "Son, please bring water for us." That time Raja King Dashrath, the father of Ram, he was also in the jungle, and he was there to make a shikar. He came there to for some visiting jungle. He was visiting jungle for just killing the deer, so that he was very fond of that. And when Shravan Kumar started filling the water from the river nearby in the kalash or in the vessel, that time some noise took place of water. Whenever we just immerse the vessel in the water, there is a one type of noise, and that noise was heard by Raja King Dashrath. So he thought that, yes, nearby that river some deer must be there, so I should make a shikar of that deer. And immediately he with his bow and arrow, he is just throwing the arrow, and he is just making the aim at that direction, and with his arrow, unfortunately, Shravan Kumar died on the spot. And then when he made a noise while dying, that what has happened to me, that time Raja Dashrath came to know that he has murdered Shravan Kumar knowingly, unknowingly, and it was very unfortunate moment for everybody. and then he came near to his parents and he was not able to disclose to them that yes, because of me your son is no more. But he gathered a courage, he gave water to his parents, and then he told his parents that unfortunately, with misunderstanding, your son is no more in this world, and because of me he is no more in this world. That time parents of Shravan Kumara were in so agony, they were in so helpless moment, and they cursed King Dashrath that the way we will cry for our child in remaining life, same way you will also cry for love and affection of your son. And you know the Ramayana, what happened. Always the Raja Dashrath was crying for the love and affection of Lord Rama. So that curse came to be true, and similarly it is said that these stars in the sky are named after Shravan Bal, Shravan Kumar, and that is why it is also said that people born under this nakshatra, if they curse anybody by heart, that curse happened to be true. So whoever are born in Shravan Nakshatra, they should take care of it, that they are not cursing anybody, because those words are coming true. Now this Shravan star is also called as foot of Vaman. Vaman is one of the avatara of Vishnu, because the deity of this nakshatra is Vishnu Devata. This nakshatra is in one line, the stars are in one line, that is why it is also called as Trikand Nakshatra. The people born under this nakshatra are highly intellectual people, highly emotional people, they are dedicated towards any work, they are very sharp, and they want to know, they are very inquisitive of everything, they want to know everything what is happening around. At the same time, these people are coming up with their own efforts and with their own struggles, they are not taking much help of anybody else. Whether so as in Hasta Nakshatra, if you will see, Hasta Nakshatra is a Paravalambi, means these people depend on other people, Hasta Nakshatra born. But Shravan Nakshatra born people, they don't depend on anybody, they take their own decisions, because this nakshatra comes in Makar Rashi, that is in Capricorn sign, and Mars is exalted in this sign. That is why they are also very bold by nature, Shravan people. One drawback of these people are they think like a deer. Means, see, deer runs so fast, within a few seconds that will disappear from your eyesight when deer is running. Same way these people's thoughts are running like a deer, but when the actual time comes to convert these thoughts into an action, that time these people are getting afraid, or they are just back footing, or they are not able to put their thoughts into an action. So they are very good advisor, they are very good thinkers. So people born under this nakshatra, they should be very good, they should go into counseling, they should go into consultation, they should go into public sector advising people rather than putting their own efforts in the work, because that will make them exhausted, they will get tired soon, because they are very sensitive by nature, they are very sensitive by health also many a times. Sun is said to be, Surya is said to be very good in this nakshatra, because sun and moon both are very good friends, and sun here will give very good results in terms of government relations, in terms of very high profile jobs. If this nakshatra moon is there in the chart, and if other placement of planets like Jupiter, Saturn are very weak, still this nakshatra will make people go into some small scale businesses like grocery shops, provision stores. If Mars is very powerful in this nakshatra along with Sun also in the chart, these people, we see they are going into police, means they are going into army, they are going into military. If Mercury and Venus are good along with this moon in the chart, they are becoming very good art directors, you know. Also they are very good singers also, if we see, if moon is very prominent in the chart. These people's shoulders are very strong because Shravan Kumar, it is, see, all mythological stories are connected because Shravan Kumar used to take the weight of his parents on his shoulders. That is why it is said that these people's shoulders and thighs are very strong. And always, in other terms, if we want to correlate this, that doesn't mean that they are just carrying weight, these people, Shravan people. But what happens, they like to take all the responsibilities every time. They will take other people's responsibilities also on them. And it happens certain times that they are not able to fulfill the each responsibility. Now the four charan in this nakshatra are first charan born people. The first charan is of Mars, second charan is of Venus, third charan is of Mercury, and fourth charan is of moon. So people born in moon charan, they are very creative by nature. In Mercury charan, they are very calculative, business oriented, profession oriented people, psychologically little bit disturbed also. If they are born in Venus charan, that is in second charan, if people are born under this nakshatra, so they are very looking wise, they are beautiful, their voice is very soothing, their voice is very soft, they sing good, they think good, they are very good poetry writers. If people are born in first charan, that is Mars charan, so they are brave, they are bold, and they take quick decisions also many times. Good financial position, you see. No matter, we have to see other planetary positions also, but in general we can say all these qualities are there in the native. Now going ahead, we will come that who is the nakshatra tree for this natives. So in routine, the nakshatra tree for these natives is Rui, R-U-I. You can just type it in Google. In common language, in English, it is called as milkweeds. Okay, because this plant is very milky and very sticky also. So many a times in Ayurveda, this sticky thing is taken into consideration, and this thing is used for skin diseases, but not unless and until doctor is advising this. So coming back to the tree of this nakshatra, that is a Rui, that is a milkweeds, and the flower of it are purple in color. They are having five petals. These flowers of milkweed is having five petals. They are purple and white in color. It is also called as madar, this flower, and this is the favorite flower of Lord Shiva and Lord Ganesha also. And the leaf of milkweed, they are making garland of this leaf, and this leaf is offered to Hanumanji, Maruti, and you can just write your wish on this leaf and just offer it to Hanumanji. It is said that this Maruti will listen each and every wish, and it will be fulfilled also. No, unless your heart is pure, unless your wish is pure, and unless you are not thinking bad about anybody, or you are not asking to do bad about anybody. So this should be there, and your true karmas, your dedication will definitely make you success in your wish, which will come true. Going ahead, about this nakshatra tree, for everybody it is not possible to keep this plant at home. So instead of that, you can just keep mango plant in the house. You can just make a bonsai of it, or you can just put a mango leaf with you always. This is also very useful. So that is an alternative tree for this. Now, as the deity of this nakshatra is Vishnu Devata, see, out of 18 Puranas, 5 Puranas are of Vishnu only. So if you want to worship Vishnu Devata, if in your chart you want to strengthen and enhance Jupiter power, if you want to enhance Mercury power, and even though you don't want any remedy, but still you want your life to be smooth and good, so just start reciting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya on this nakshatra itself. And when you finish chanting mantras, say you are chanting it for 10 minutes or you are just chanting it 108 times. So when you are concluding with the mantras, at the last 3 times, you just have to chant Om Vishnuve Namaha, Om Vishnuve Namaha, Om Vishnuve Namaha. These 3 times you have to chant. And whenever you are in sorrow, whenever you are in worry, whenever you are in stress, you can always go for this Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. This is the best remedy, because mantras has the major and best power than any other remedy. So here your positivity, the mantra chanting, the pronunciation of mantra, really it works well to uplift your good aura, to just diminish your sorrows. Now going ahead, if we will think about the murtas, so this nakshatra can be done for any good occasion except marriage, because this is a very sorrowful nakshatra. So under this nakshatra, marriage should not happen because of certain mythological stories behind it. Also, this nakshatra people immediately they are very negative approach people, so they have to work on it, because moon is there in Saturn sign, because Capricorn is a Saturn nakshatra. That is why the flower of madar and leaf of milkweed, that is rui, is offered to Hanumanji. That is why this remedy is given. See, everybody has connection with the nakshatra, deities, Vishnu Sahasranam, everything. Nothing has come automatically. This everything is written in our Shastras. This is the Vedic method to worship our deities, our devatas, and just improve our aura. So I hope many things are clear with you. So next time I will come with another nakshatra. So by that time, stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology. And one more thing, on 8th of every month, 8th of every month, I will be giving certain services. I will be answering your queries via email by taking very, very little and affordable dakshina, because nothing should be given in free. At least I believe that, so that it will be beneficial to you also and me also. So I will be answering those queries. So do take benefit of those this scheme. You can just go through my website planettosoul.com and you can just book your consultation over there, special day consultation. And other than that also, you can visit it. You will really find my website very good. This is very divine. At least I feel that. I always get good vibes from that, and I wish that all of you also get very good vibes from the website. So by that time, stay tuned. Bye-bye and take care.